Hi friends! One of my beautiful wildfire yogis named Beth asked for a yoga for bedtime, yoga for sleep video. And I got really excited because like restorative yoga is my thing and like bedtime yoga, it's awesome. So we're gonna act like this Raven's blanket is my bed. The lighting in my room was a little too dark for the video. TMI, but just so you know. And so all you need is a pillow, which you should already have on your bed, and your bed. No mat, nothing else. And I'm gonna start us off in a supported child's pose. I'll give two options because my bed is super soft. So in my personal bed, I wouldn't want a pillow under my belly because my bed is already super, super soft. So you can do this with feet together, knees apart with no pillow underneath of you, or grab a pillow, bring it nice and close into the body to place under the belly and the chest, and then go ahead and reach your arms forward, or super chill child's pose, elbows are bent, relax your head. Staying in child's pose, lift your head and just turn your head over to the other side to even out the neck. And turn your head to center, remembering, like I always say, you can pause the video and stay here for as long as you'd like, but I'm going to continue to move on. Keep the pillow where it is, or if you don't have your pillow, grab your pillow, place it under the belly. We're just going to take a few cat-cows, and cat-cows on the bed are a little different than the floor. Like the springs in the mattress make it feel a little bit different. So nice and gentle, inhale cow pose, draw the belly down to the earth. Press away from the bed and look straight ahead. I'm like Dr. Seuss when I teach yoga. It's the only time I rhyme, and it's on accident. Go ahead and round through your spine, tuck your tailbone, draw your chin to chest for your cat pose. And then inhale, cow pose. Belly comes down, look straight ahead. Exhale, round the spine for cat. Do that about two more times. Inhale, cow. Exhale, cat. Inhale and exhale. And come to a neutral spine. This one always puts me to sleep. I want you to turn on to your side. So I'm on my right side. Pillow is gonna be under our rib cage and under like our underarm. So laying onto the pillow, stretch your right arm forward. Bring your left hand onto the pillow or onto the bed. And then I want you to bend your knees and either stack them if that's comfortable. If it's not comfortable, bring your top knee onto your calf. And then you're gonna rest here. I prefer my hand on the pillow, but if your hand feels better on the bed, keep it there. And you're just gonna rest here for a moment. My heat is kicking on. I want to turn it off so I do not disturb the video. And go ahead and make your way onto the left side doing the same thing. So you're going to turn over to your left hip. Pillows under the rib cage and our arm. Stretch your left arm forward. Bring your right hand onto the pillow. Knees are stacked or top knee is on our calf. I always turn around because it's not very helpful for you to just look at my backside. So you can see the pose from another angle. right, we're going to make our way onto our backs for Supta Baddha Konasana. I do want your back and your head to be supported. So if you're like me and your one pillow doesn't support your head, only supports your lower back, I want you to grab another pillow. It doesn't have to be the same height. I'm not worried about that. I just want your neck supported, not super, super lower. So go ahead and bring either your one pillow or the pillow closest to you right under your back in your sacrum. And then bring your other pillow that's for your head right under your head. Feet together, knees apart. Interlace your fingers over your belly. Another option, one hand on belly, one hand on heart. Third option is just your arms resting at your sides. Remember that you can pause the video and stay here. Go ahead and stretch your legs long in your bed as you're ready, keeping the pillows where they are. Plant your hands and your forearms onto your bed. Go ahead and press yourself up to a seat. Place your pillow off to the side for a moment. Or just take a pillow under your head, actually. One or the other. No pillow or pillow just under your head. I want you to inhale the arms up and overhead. And then exhale, draw your knees into your chest. Press your lower back into the bed. Take a pause here. You can take time to twist. I love twist. Bringing your right hand to the outside of your left knee. Letting the knees drop over to the right. Left arm stretches out to the left and you turn your head. And then you'd obviously repeat that on the other side. Bringing knees to center and letting knees drop off to the left. Hand hooks on the outside of the thigh. Right arm opens, turning your head to the right. Bring your legs back to center. Then just for our back, cross knee over knee. Grab ankles. A different option is figure four. right ankle to left thigh. You can grab your thigh or grab the shin. So grab right ankle, my right ankle is on top of my left knee. I just interlaced my hands behind the thigh or on the shin. Obviously repeat on the other side, left ankle to right thigh. Draw the legs in, interlace, shin or thigh, same pose, no difference. Go ahead and try these poses. Listen to some soft music. Soft, something that you won't like try to bump to or shake to, you know what I mean? Or listen to silence for once. I hope this helps you get some yummy, yummy sleep, some good rest. If it doesn't, read a book. Read a boring book. That will always help. Lay there, eyes closed. The beauty and light within me honors the beauty and light within you. Namaste.